Hello everyone, and welcome to Extreme Tech Channel. In today's video we got the 1GF, it's a structural weld test, flat position, which is groove and fillet weld. As you can see, one side of the plate is beveled 45 degree angle and the other one is a square edge. This is typical Canadian CWB weld test, covers only flat position. For me, this is one of the easiest weld tests, but there's people also there fail. This is one example that got bent and failed. There's a couple of reasons. It can be insufficient heat, poor manipulation technique. You can see the lack of fusion. The cause might be when you allow your paddle to flop against the square plate instead of pointing the arc at the square edge of the plate. Holding a long arc, incorrect restart technique, that's why stop starts are important. Incorrect electrode angle, poor manipulation. Okay, for this I'm gonna use 134, 135. It's a good habit, dial in before you start your test actually. Dial in your welding machine so you don't have any issues. So we already marked where we're gonna, stop. There's a mark on both sides. You have to stop and then you gotta take that coupon to welding examiner. As you can see here, I'm just pretty much, there's not big manipulation except that rod inclination, the rod angle, just lean between that edge and the backing strip and let it burn by itself. It's a pull technique. With that amperage, you should be good from beginning all the way to the cap. You shouldn't be have to change anything, pretty much. Okay, now we're gonna do on the other side. So the only rod allowed for this test is a 1/8, 7/18. We're not allowed to use any other size of the stick rod. So once you've done those two beads, as I said, you have to go and take the welding examiner and then he will tell you to continue on in the same direction, which is very important. For this test, no grinders are allowed. Saw blades, files or methods that remove deposit metal or alter weld bead profile, they're not permitted. You got only 45 minutes. It's a good habit for your stop start. Always restart the arc ahead of the crater where you stopped, then move back into the crater. Fill it and continue to weld. Technique for the fill passes is it's up to welder, but it's generally considered easier and there's less chance of leaving a defect in the weld if the stringer passes are used. As you know, this is only stringer passes, and which is the best to prevent from any slag or lack of fusion or whatever. That's why you don't want to have any slag, especially on a flat. I don't know, I've seen a couple videos on YouTube, the guy saying that this is one of the hardest tests, it's tricky. I will really disagree with that. This should be one of the easiest out of all four tests, but if you do it properly, I mean any test can be, if you do it wrong, the any test can be hard, eh? If you don't know what you're doing. Okay, so we got two passes, as you see, we did in the same direction. Now we're gonna fill one in the middle. Still using the same thing, same amperage, 135. You won't go wrong with that amperage. Basically, you're putting down layers of beads until you got up to the, you want to fill it to flash, so you can cap it. As I said, no grinders, no saw blades. You can use a buffing wheel. It's a good one tip. Use buffing wheel when the plate is still hot. I mean, it's a small plate. It's gonna be hot pretty much all the time because you got 45 minutes. But if you lean and push a little bit harder on that buffing wheel, you can actually have a, if you got any buildup or something, you can smooth it out easy with a buffing wheel. You don't need a grinder. Okay, this is where I start on that backing plate, there's a little window on the all four sides that you can have a little whatever, and even a bead, or you can have little mistakes on those corners, because that's gonna be cut. They're not gonna be used, that corners, for later for bend. It's gonna be three strips out of that plate. They're gonna bend. And pretty much that's what you do. You just laying down the beads. You always start and go on the corner. Okay, now we feel that straight edge. Now I'm gonna move on that bevel one. The only thing I can say here, just make sure that you never weaving up against a square cut plate. Always point to the square cut plate when welding, especially for that, as I said, that square straight one. Okay, now we're gonna just keep on filling. As you can see, just stringer bits. That's it, pretty much. I don't know, did I mention, but after you done your first two passes on each side, after welding examiner say it's okay, you can do either direction. So it's crucial for first two passes, your stop starts gotta be in the same direction. After that, you can left to right, right to left, whatever it's easier to you. That's what I like to do. There's not big manipulation or weaving or anything. I'm just holding rod, just have that nice angle, that rod inclination, and let it just melt inside. It's always advantage with stringer bits, especially on the multi-passes like this. It's nice and blended. There's no porosity, there's no slag, nothing. Now you just keep filling, keep going. I always want to do the straight edge first. And one rod is enough for the whole length, so you don't have to stop. That's why you don't want to manipulate too much, just in case if you run out of the rod and you didn't finish the entire bead by the end of that plate, then you gotta do stop start again. Basically, you just want to stop start on beginning of your test. That's what those two requirements are. But other than that, one rod should be enough for entire bead for the length of that test coupon. Okay, now just continue on. Filling that middle. Until it's even and flush. For the fillet size, the fillet weld size is 8mm or 5/16 max. This means that you can put on 5mm or 3/16, on 6mm quarter or 8mm 5/16 fillet weld. The legs of the fillet weld must not vary in size by more than 1.5mm or 1/16 inch. As I said, those corners are really not important that much. It's more to get your rod warm up on a working temperature, and so you can have a nice proper bead on a spot that's gonna be cut and bend. So as I said, there is that little window on those corners that you can have any, it doesn't have to be beautiful, have any mistake. Here I am, as you can see here, I am actually manipulating that rod, burning between that bead I have and that's the straight edge. Just trying to make it feel uneven, because there is a little wider space in between. It's not gonna be filled if I'm just holding that rod. It's gonna stay. That's why I wanna cover. This is the only one part that's a little bit wider, and that's why I'm doing that. Okay, we're probably gonna have four passes for the cap. Okay, start again. Start on a straight edge, on that straight cut side. It's not big, there's no science fiction in this, just hold that rod, make it nice and square. You don't want to have any undercuts. You can have some, but not that much. And now we're gonna put one more bead on this side. I think it says the maximum undercut should not exceed 0.8 mil, which is inch and 30 seconds. Okay, now we got those three passes. Now we're gonna put one more on this side, and that should be done with a cap. As I said, you only got 45 minutes for this. So if you do proper steps as I did in this video, you shouldn't have any problems. As I said, for me, the flat is one of the easiest welds. I don't know why some guys on YouTube, some welding gurus, they're making big science fiction out of flat. I mean, if you got a hard time in a flat, like what's gonna happen in overhead, or which is same as flat but opposite. It's a gravity. The biggest issue with the 4GF is a gravity. But for this one, I mean, you shouldn't have really any problems. Vertical is a little bit different story, or horizontal. Well, your weld can sag down, or vertical, the same gravity, overhead. So out of all those four, this should be the easiest one. Okay, and then I did the final pass. Okay, now we got four passes cap. As I said, this is weld test, doesn't have to be beautiful, it's nice and uniform, that's all matters. Now they cut like three pieces. You gotta clean it around the edges. When you're doing root or you're removing that backing strip, always go cross with your grinder. You don't want to chase it, don't go too deep. Around the edges, make it nice and clean. And now we go for bend. It's a one root and two face, if I'm not mistaken. And there it is. That's it. That's our flat. It's all good. I got others. I did four tests here, and I hope there's gonna be more material for next videos. Hope you guys like it, enjoyed, and see you in the next one. Play safe. Thanks.